The main advantage of hashing with linear probing instead of linked lists is a large reduction in space requirements. There are no linked lists. Instead, the elements of the set are kept directly in an array B. We show the array for an empty set. Empty array elements are assumed to contain null. As usual, an element E1 is hashed to a bucket, and if the bucket contains null, E is placed there. If another element E2 hashes to an occupied bucket, a collision is said to have occurred, and E2 must be placed elsewhere. In linear probing, it is placed in the next bucket to the right with wraparound that is null. We show the placement of two more values that hash to buckets 6 or 7. In summary, if an element hashes to bucket H, the element is placed in the first of the following buckets that contains null: bucket H, bucket H plus 1, remainder B dot length, bucket H plus 2, remainder B dot length, and so on. Searching for an element involves hashing it to a bucket and looking at that bucket and the following buckets in wraparound fashion until either the element is found or null is found, in which case the element is not in the set. Suppose E1, E2, and E3 all hashed to 6 and were added as shown. A test of whether E3 is in the set is successful. A test whether E4 is in the set is not successful. Suppose E2 is removed. Now, a test of whether E3 is in the set is unsuccessful because linear probing stops as soon as a null bucket is found. Clearly, removing E2 cannot be done simply by setting the bucket to null. Instead, we use a Boolean value for each bucket to indicate whether the bucket contains a value or not. Removing E2 then consists only in setting its Boolean to false. Now, testing for the presence of a value in the set consists of testing not only the bucket but the Boolean that indicates whether the value is in the set.